Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, are you listening? Are you listening to the voices of women in this room giving compelling arguments? I would say, is the legislature listening? But I have to address you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I want to continue Crystal's story. Using Crystal's words, as you recall, Crystal couldn't afford health insurance while she worked a minimum wage job, and she couldn't afford to refill her birth control prescription. She couldn't afford to use contraception. She became pregnant. After struggling with the decision of what to do, she decided to keep the pregnancy. She started having stabbing pains in her abdomen and back. Her leg would go numb. She vomited. She could literally not function for a couple of weeks. So she went to a Christian Urgent Care. They sent her to an ER with concerns of an ectopic pregnancy. After 8 hours alone in urgent care and the ER, it was determined that the heart rate of the fetus was a little fast. They decided she should just wait it out because there were still fetal heart tones. The nurse clapped and bounced because it could mean she'd have a boy. She sat doubled over in pain, trying not to cry. Crystal waited it out for another day or two, but the pain was unbearable, and she couldn't miss more work, so she found a Planned Parenthood. They said she was 3 weeks further along than the ER had said. She was told that the symptoms were consistent with a miscarriage, which has been agreed upon by other doctors in the 7 years since then, and that she could wait out the miscarriage. They explained what she could experience and how to handle it. But she was also told that if the pain was too much to bear, she had the option of an abortion, so she chose the abortion. Had this forced ultrasound bill been in effect, she would have been forced to listen to someone describe the fetus that she knew she was miscarrying. She would have been forced to watch the ultrasound image. This bill is wrong. Where are our priorities? Wisconsin ranks dead last in short-term job growth. Dead last. We are 49th in economic outlook. We are 44th in job growth, 45th in wage growth, and 49th in job growth through 2016. So, Mr. Speaker, how many jobs would this bill create for our state today? People are desperate for employment. They are clamoring for the security of a paycheck and the dignity of a living wage. With this week commemorating 50 years after the Equal Pay Act, 97% of women working full-time still earn less than their male counterparts. That's with 40% of all households with children in this country, where mothers are the head of household. It was just 11% in 1960. So why aren't we focusing on jobs if we want to help women today? Why aren't we giving Wisconsin women the resources they need to thrive? Instead of granting women and their families access to equal pay and expanded paid family leave, the majority party is forcing transvaginal ultrasounds on them. Instead of creating a single job to support the 40% of households with women as the head of household, the majority party is forcing an unnecessary procedure on women who are already in a difficult situation, a situation like the one I just described to you. Women should be valued, not legislated against. Yet you've legislated against us again and again and again. You've defunded programs at Planned Parenthood that provide critical and life-saving cancer screenings. You've refused to take the Badger Care expansion, which could cover an additional 85,000 people. You've cut into the earned income tax credits, which working women rely on to help raise their families. You've made enough steps today and in the past to show us where you stand. And you don't stand with women. I seem to remember just a few months ago, Republicans conducting a postmortem after November 2012, taking inventory of what went wrong and where they could do better. I seem to remember that women are the ones you're supposed to be reaching out to. But however, instead of having women at the table, you have us on the menu. Mr. Speaker, women have rights, women have choice, women have priorities, and we prioritize our health. And Mr. Speaker, women vote.